Hello friends, welcome back to our tutorial, Designing an Impressive Architectural Building in AutoCAD 2018 Imperial. If you have been following along, go and open the file 00_019_BIAB where you saved it, or go and download this file. You can also sit down and watch or follow along with your own files. Now zooming into this area and select this 3D modeling. Select this model, this slab. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the move command. At the prompt, specify base point prompt. Use this vertex as the base point. At the specify second point, or use the first point as a displacement point. Go and turn off your auto mode. Now move into this area and click on this vertex. You can hold down your shift key and use your middle mouse button to get a better orientation. Place this model into this area. Now AutoCAD copy the model into the right place. Select this slab and go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the move command. At the specified base point, click into this area. Now move down your cursor, go and turn off on the model if you turn it off recently, and move down. Type 1 foot on your keyboard and press enter. AutoCAD move the slab into the right location. Go and select this file and erase it. Use a different preset view to see the result of your work. Go to the view control and click the custom view. Select the top, then select the bottom. Although the bottom view is not much useful in architectural drawing, go and select the left view. This gives you one of the elevation. Select right, another elevation. Front, back, SW isometric. Upper the mouse cursor into the UCS and right click, select world. You can also turn off the grid to have a better understanding how the model looks. Click the V cube and select SE isometric. Select NE isometric. Select NW isometric. Select this slab, go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the move command. Click into this area and move down to the negative Z direction. Turn on your auto mode if it's off and type 1 foot on your keyboard and press enter. Now select the foundation and this slab. Right click into the drawing area and hover the mouse cursor to isolate and isolate object. AutoCAD hide all the other objects except the object that you select for the isolate command. We need to reduce the height of this wall. To do that, go and turn on your cabbage layer if the cabbage layer is not the current layer. Go to the home tab, draw panel, and select the line command. At the specified start point prompt, start the line into this area and move the line. When you see the perpendicular object snap, click, press enter to end the command. Press enter again to start the command. Start another line from this point to this point. Press escape. Press enter to start another line again. Start another line from this point to this point. Press escape to get out of the command. Now go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the fillet command. Select this line and this line. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the press pull command. Hover your mouse cursor above this area and click. Now move your mouse down until you snap at the edge of this slab. Press escape to get out of the command. Now select this temporal line that you just drew to as reference and hit the delete key on your keyboard. Select this line and delete it. Right click into the drawing area and hover the mouse cursor to the word isolate. Follow the window that pop up and select end object isolation. Now select this line this line and go to the Home tab, Modify panel, and select the Move command. At the Specify base point prompt, click at this corner. Then at the Specifying second point or use the first point at displacement, click on this corner. It will add move the object in the right location. All right, in this tutorial, you copy the first floor above the ground floor. In the next tutorial, we'll start to build our roof. If you found this tutorial useful to you, please click the like button and share it to your colleague. If you have any question or you want a specific tutorial, please leave a comment below. If you want to follow along on this series or any other tutorial on my channel, please subscribe. Thanks very much for watching. I hope to see you in the next class. Goodbye.